Good morning, dear students. I hope everyone is fine at home. And so let's start with our science class. In PE 2, 5 chapters are there. Chapter 2, 4, 10, 15, 17. These chapters I have completed, and you have completed in your copy. So I will start with annual. So in annual examination, 3 chapters are there: chapter 3, chapter 6, chapter 12. So in annual examination, these 8 chapters will come: 2, 4, 10, 15, 17, 3, 6, 12. So chapter 3, eating habits of animals. Chapter 3 is the eating habits of animals. So these chapters I have completed in the class, eating habits of animals, and in this I discussed about the different kinds of animals, means plant eating animals, or we can say that herbivorous animals, those who are eating flesh of those who are eating plants and plant products of the those who are eating plants and plant products are called the herbivorous, or we can say that plant eating animals. Example: cow, giraffe, deer, zebra, oxen, yaks. These are the animals, those who are eating plants and plant products. So they are called the herbivorous, or we can say that in plant eating animals. Plant eating animals, by this term you can recognize that animals, those who are eating only plants, they are called the plant eating animals. And flesh eating animals, they are called the carnivorous animals, those who are eating flesh of other animals, or we can say that those who are eating meat of other animals, so they are called the flesh eating animals. Or we can see that carnivorous animals: lion, tiger, leopard, snakes, frogs, sharks are the examples of carnivorous or flesh eating animals. Animals, those who are eating flesh of the other animals, are called the carnivorous animals. And both plants and flesh eating animals, they are called the omnivorous. Omni means both. O-M-N-I. Omni means both. So animals, those who are eating plants as well as the meat of the or flesh of the other animals, they are called the omnivorous. Those who are eating both, herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. Herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. So according to their eating habits, animals are categorized into three categories, that is the herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. And herbivorous animals, plant eating animals, those who are eating plants and plant products are called the herbivorous animals. Examples: cow, giraffe, goats, deer, elephant, these are the example of the herbivorous animals. Carnivorous animals, those who are eating flesh of the other animals, they are called the flesh eating animals or carnivorous. Examples: lion, tiger, snake, frogs, these are the example of the flesh eating or carnivorous animals. Omnivorous animals, those who are eating both flesh and plant products are called the omnivorous animals. Examples: human beings and crow, peacock, bear, dog, rat. These are the omnivorous. They are eating both. And then how animals eat? So they have different types of teeth, jaws, and according to their eating habits, they are categorized. And you know that some animals live mainly on liquid food. Just like butterflies and bees suck nectars from the flowers, and they have a long tube like tongue, and that they help in sucking nectar from the flowers. And you know that mosquito and bugs, they suck blood from the human beings and they use it as food. Dogs and cats lap up milk. Food chain. I explained in this chapter 3, eating habits of animals, food chain. Food chain is the sequence in which it is given who eats who, किसने किसको खाया, and it is a sequence and it is balancing in the nature, so it maintains balance in the nature. It starts with the green plants, and ends with the flesh eater. Food chain is a sequence in which it is given who eats whom. किसने किसको खाया. So this starts with the green plants. Green plants eaten by the caterpillar. Caterpillar eaten by the frog. Frog is eaten by the snake. Snake is eaten by an owl. So these are the sequence and it maintains a balance in the nature. So this is the food chain. Already these things I explained in the class, but again I am telling you as a revision. So food chain, I think all of you understood. I explained in the class also. Who eats whom, that is the sequence and sequence of food chain. And domestic animals, you know that domestic animals are very useful to us. They help us in many ways. And so it's our duty, if they are fall sick, then we have to take to the veterinary doctor and clean them by giving bath or wash regularly and take them to a veterinary hospital when they fall sick. It's our duty. So these are these things about the chapter 3, eating habits of animals. So till here I all have understood half of the explanation I have given in the class, and question answers also fill in that till match the following from chapter 3. I explained in the class, I have given in the class, I think all of you completed in the copy also. Only answer the following is remaining, but through the PDF I will send you again, and you have to write in your science copy chapter 3. Understood? So I will start with chapter 6. Next chapter of the annual examination is the chapter 6. These are the safety rules. Let's start with chapter 6, safety rules. Safety rules. Lesson 6, safety rules. Safety rules. Chapter 6, safety rules. So first I will read this chapter. Pre-reading question. Some questions are given. Say right or wrong. You will say, I will read, and you will also read with me, and you will say it's right or wrong. Your friend is crossing the road without looking to the right or the left. Sometimes when you are in hurry-burry, or sometimes it is in your habit, without looking right, without looking left, immediately you are crossing the road. You are crossing the road, that is very dangerous. You can get hurt. So this is the wrong thing. Your friend is crossing the road without looking to the right, without looking to the left. This is the wrong. First you will look right, then left, then again you have to look right, then you can cross the road. Your younger sister is playing in the kitchen near a burning gas stove. This is also wrong thing. You always keep your things at proper place. That is good habit. It's your duty. You should keep your things at proper place. It's your duty. So you should keep your things at the proper place. And when you will keep like this, then it is a good habit. So it is right. If you are keeping your things at proper place, that is the best habit. That is the good manner also, and it is good. And easily next day, when you will keep your things at proper place, then next day you can get your things easily. You always play in the park, right? Always play in the outdoor areas, so it is better. Aim to tell the students or to tell the children about safety rules to be observed everywhere, in the house, in the school, on the road, in the park, etc. So in this chapter we will discuss about if safety at home. If we are at home, then what are the safety rules? And then safety at school. If we are in the school, then which rules we should follow? Safety on the road. And what is the first A? First F. So these are the topics which are given in this chapter, and we will discuss about this chapter. So what is the right, what is the wrong? I think all of you understood. Your friend is crossing the road without looking to the right or left. It is wrong thing. First you you should look right, then left, left, then again right, then you can cross the road. Your younger sister is playing in the kitchen near a burning gas stove. That is also a wrong thing. You always keep your things at proper place. That is a good habit. Always you keep your things at the proper place. It is good for you. And you always play in the park. Yes, that is also right thing. Everyone wants a safe and protected life. Yes, we want, you want, everybody wants a safe and protected life. Sometimes you can see accidents can happen at any place. It can happen at any place because we are not taking proper care. That's why it happens. So it's our duty, anywhere, any place, if we are there, then we should follow some rules and regulations are there. If we will follow, then it is good for us. So but when something happens suddenly and causes damage or injury, it is called an accident. Yes, so anything can happen at any time, any place. If suddenly anything will happen, then it causes damage or injury, and it is called an accident. Accident can happen anytime, anywhere. Yes, it can happen at any time, anywhere. You can avoid accidents if you are a little more careful. If you are careful, then you can avoid accidents. You must follow safety rules everywhere, at home, in school, and on the road. So you must follow safety rules everywhere. If you are at home, if you are in the school, and if you are on the road. So some rules are there, some regulations are there. If you will follow, then it is good for you. And then we can save and we can avoid small accidents. We can avoid different kinds of accident which can happen at any time, anywhere, at any place. So it's our duty, we should follow that rules and regulations. And for this we must be careful. If we are in the kitchen, then also we should be careful. So this is the about safety rules. And in next topic I will explain safety at home. If we are at home, then which kind of safety we should follow? So till here you will take a revision.